Hello friends, I am Naval Yemul, working as an assistant professor in mechanical department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, we are going to see classes and objects. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to learn and develop the programs using classes and objects in C++. Content. Introduction. Second is specifying a class, objects, then defining member functions, and lastly we are going to see a program based on class and objects. Introduction. Definition of a class. The class is a collection of objects of similar type. The entire set of data and code can be made user defined with the help of a class. Objects are the variables of type class. Once the class has been defined, we can create any number of its object. We'll see the examples in the next slides. Specifying a class. So the class is defined by a class keyword. And the class contains data members, which is also called as attributes. The class has operations or member functions or methods. The body of class is enclosed within braces and terminated by a semicolon. The class contains declaration of variables and functions. The variables and functions are collectively called as members. The variable declared inside the class are known as data members, and the functions are known as member functions. Yeah, the important point in classes are access specifiers or visibility levels are classified in two parts. Those are public and private. So the general form of class declaration is mentioned below here. So the class is a keyword, and the student is a class name. So inside the braces, they have a class, private and public. So the data members should always be in private, and the member functions should always be in public. So we'll see in detail what is private and public, that is access specifiers, in the next slide. So here, as the figure 1 shows, in private you have data members as well as member functions. In public you have the data members and member functions, but in public can only be accessed from outside the class also, but in private is accessed only within the class, and there is no entry outside the class. So the whatever you write in private, that can be accessed only within the class, and no one from outside the class can access the private data. But whatever we write in public, we can access within the class also and outside the class also. So this is a representation of the classes. So next we're going to see objects. Objects are the basic runtime entities in object-oriented systems. They may represent a place, a bank account, a table of data, or any item that the program must handle. For example, here class is a keyword and rectangle is a class name. Then, as we have discussed, private and public. Private, the data members, like we have taken a data type integer, length, breadth and area. Public, we can write public here, member functions. Then your main program starts here, that is void main. Then class name is called, that is rectangle. After rectangle, R1 and R2 are the objects which are created in this example. So the example of class and object. So we'll see the example of real life entities like fruit. Here in fruit we have many types like mango, apple and banana. Here the fruit is a class, and mango, apple, banana, you can create n number of objects. These are called as objects. So you can see one more example of class and object. Like you can call a car as a class, and inside the car you have n number of objects can be created, like Mercedes, then BMW, then Audi. These can be called as objects. So objects are created with the help of real life problems or real life entities, and objects can be created n number of times. So here, while defining a member functions, it can be of two types, that is defining or outside the class definition, and second is inside the class definition. So we'll see the examples of outside the class definition and inside the class definition. So here, first number, that is outside the class definition, shows here class rectangle. We have taken private and public. In private, data members are mentioned. In public, member functions are mentioned. So the class is terminated by semicolon. After the class, we have called the class again, that is void rectangle. Then we have used scope resolution operator and accept. Then we can write in within the bracket like cout, cin. Void rectangle we can calculate there, and then by using void rectangle we can display the output. So the first shows the outside the class definition. Similarly, if we see the inside the class definition, here also we have taken a class rectangle, private there are data members, but here the difference between outside and inside is, here in public data member functions are defined, and after that they have data members. After the member functions, they have directly given the brackets, and here cout and cin is used, and in void calculates the calculations are done and the display is given. So here you can see the difference in outside the class. After terminating the class, then again we call the class here, but inside the class definition we use the member functions inside the class itself. So we'll see a program using the class. Write a program to declare a class rectangle having data members length and breadth. Accept this data for one object and display area and perimeter of rectangle. So I'll give you a few seconds to think on the program using class as a rectangle and data members as length and breadth. You can pause the video for 10-15 seconds, then think. Okay, so here I have done a program in Turbo C++. So here class rectangle is used. I have taken the data members like integer, length, breadth and area. Then public, so void, I have done the program with the help of inside the class definition. So you can see inside the class the member functions are defined. Void, accept, then cout and cin, enter the length and breadth, and those are stored in L and B. The next member function is void calculate. A is a variable again, so A equal to L into breadth, and next member function is void display, cout display A. So now the class is terminated. The main program starts here, that is void main. I have called the class name as rectangle, followed by a object. I am creating a object R. The next line, R dot accept, R dot calculate, and R dot display, get ch, and the output for this program will be enter the length and breadth. If you enter 5 as length and 6 as breadth, the output will be 30. So these are the references I have used. Thank you.